I guess this intro music's better than the
There's only two tracks. Actually, there's technically three songs in this whole game. Oh my god. Maybe we should switch sides. Maybe you should be on this side. No, I'll be on this side because this has more of the stuff. Okay.
Yeah, you can deal with all that while I play the game.
While you play the game? Well, like, don't start just
yeah.
yet.
There's a part in this game where it's where you get married and it goes, you'll be in the Bennett, your wife will be something that will be good in the Benedict family or whatever. And what I did is I screenshotted that and I changed it to Del Vecchio family. So I'm holding on to it until I get married, and then I'll post it on Facebook.
Oh, nice.
So, yeah, no, you'll see what I mean where you, when I get married in this game.
Okay, I want to see you get married.
It'll say Benedict.
I'm going to see you legit get married, too.
I love this guy's personality.
Hi, Liam Piper. Good coffee. Oh my gosh, we had such like a horrible setup this morning. I was actually fully dressed in a business suit, and like we talked before doing this, and Tony was gonna wear a suit too, and he came over looking like that. And I was like, oh, I had to change out of my costume. Tony.
Yeah, I know.
So yeah, no costume. This is my pal Tony. Wave to the nice people, Tony.
Hello, internet.
Hello. Oh, my hair sucks too. I literally just woke up. I was like watching like Godzilla stuff. That's how I passed out last night. I was watching Godzilla stuff. Okay, give me a few more minutes. I just need to like wake up. Now that I got that mess taken care of. Where's all my stuff? It's my coffee. My coffee's there. Can we come back here so I can walk back here too? And I can be like, hello. Just getting set up. Tony's just gonna sit there on the couch enjoying the music. Tony, enjoy the music.
I'll enjoy it.
How are you reading all these names, Tony?
Dion the Dashing Designer.
Wow, he's
Julie
dashing.
The Jolly Jeweler. Austin the Astute Auctioneer. New game. You guys are legit for this early bird Twitch stream.
Oh yeah, you know it. You know it, Techno. I'm like, I'll just fly in here. Zip. Okay, this game has a lot of reading. See, I can still wear my glasses and we're ready for this shit.
I like the Wall Street Kids.
Carl, the cranky car dealer. We get to buy a car. Look at all these people we're never going to meet in this game.
No, you meet them all. It's just for briefly.
Yeah, but if these people were playing this game and they didn't know, they didn't have the legit skills that we have, they would never meet these people.
I love how in this game, I'll give a little bit of foreshadowing. You know, Priscilla's like, let's have a party. Like,
Priscilla's really, your girlfriend.
Yeah. Like, it'll be super fun. And he's like, okay. Like, he's just like, yeah, whatever. I'll just... money. Whatever, it's just my money, it doesn't matter.
Do, do, do.
But it's Priscilla, look at her, she's just all like foxy.
She's your foxy girlfriend.
But she'll leave you if you don't have enough money.
Oh yeah, well like, that's what happens when you date a beautiful woman, Tony.
It doesn't work,
it just like, stays at home and eats bonbons. And
yeah, goes to the picnics. You have to take her out for picnics and stuff.
Picnics and crap and everything. Like, let's go shopping and everything. Okay, are we ready?
Yeah, let's
this
get this
torture.
Thing.
Let's get this over.
Yeah, I might as well get this torture over with. So, and I'm gonna try to do it in one shot.
We're gonna do this. We are going to complete Yeah, we're doing any percent Wall Street Kid. Okay, let me turn off the text. Oh, wait, we need that one. Okay, hello, I'm Larry, a lawyer employed by your distant uncle, Mr. Benedict. I'm sorry to say he's passed away. You look a little bit too friggin' happy that you, someone in your family died. His only surviving relative, you may be eligible to inherit over 600 billion in assets. You're gonna get 600 asses. Hello, Maka. You must prove yourself. You'll be provided with $500,000, which you must first turn a profit through the stock market. How excited we are to play this game! Use the profits to uphold the Benedict standard of living, pamper your sweetheart, and move into a decent $1 million house. You have 1 month to purchase the house, and I'll give your real estate agent to call you. Austin, Mr. Benedict's granddaughter owned a castle in Europe years ago. Ooh, when he immigrated to the U.S., the castle could be sold. Just before Mr. Benedict's death, he heard gossip that the castle would go up for sale. You must buy it back to maintain the family heritage. Castle drama, blah blah blah, boopity boo. Let's go with it.
April
Fool's
Day.
Okay. Oh my god! Tony, it's the sound of your nightmares. Okay, like in the spirit of the UK leaving the European Union, we're playing Wall Street Kid. Hello, my name is Ralph. I'm a real estate agent. Larry told me that you're interested in purchasing a house for around $1 million. I'm looking at some very nice homes for sale at the moment. I'll get details and call you at the beginning of next week. Bye for now. This is not a co-ed game. Or is it? No, it's a soft feel game?
Yeah. Soft jelly or soft jelly.
Yeah. Carnivore announced plans. Oh, you're going too fast. You can't read all this text.
Oh, it's going to be repetitive reading.
It's going to be very repetitive. There's our awesome little computer. This is the screen that we're going to be staring at for like the next couple of hours. Okay, so it's Monday. You got some flowers. Oh, you have to explain what you're doing, Tony.
Oh, yes. I'm taking her out for a picnic for 2 hours.
Lovely. You don't get to see it. So when you click on the interface right there, so that's like, you have to explain what that is,
yeah,
and everything.
So this is to buy and sell stock.
That's your computer.
This is the time of day. When it reaches 4 or 5 p.m., that's the end of the day. You cannot do any more transactions. If you want to end the day, you just hit that button.
Macaw actually knows the computer. It's a PC 8801.
Oh, that's pretty hardcore.
That's pretty hardcore.
This is the newspaper, so it just basically repeats all the texts from that particular day.
Yeah.
If you select this will take you to your personal goals, such as swimming and hiking and stuff, to get fit. If you do not do this on a regular basis, Priscilla will be like, you're fat.
You're getting fat.
Yeah, you're getting fat. Deal with it.
Deal with it.
Swimming. Do some swimming.
Good decision.
Transaction takes 2 hours. I like how it's like, transaction.
Transaction.
Oh, okay. And I think we're good for the day.
Like, if we were going to get this all set up, I was going to move the computer out here, have a desk, and make it look like we were all, like, business traders and shit. Ugh. Blue chips. You have to get these blue chips. Stock Bulletin, Carnivore Cruise Lines, Rattletoys, Cunningham and Road, Marriott Hotels, and Centipede. These all sound like Atari games. Local hero to be given ticker tape welcome after saving drowning guinea pig. The headlines in the newspaper make no sense.
Yeah. So I'm gonna work out more.
You're gonna work out more? You're gonna buff?
Let's do hiking.
This game is M. M for mature.
Transaction takes 8 hours. Oh, and the different transactions take either 2, 4, or 8. So if you buy and sell stocks, you can't do hiking because you need the full 8 hours.
Okay.
It'll tell you that you can't. Yeah. You know, I'll probably end up doing that.
Because we're gonna show you how you win this game. We're gonna show you how to win the stock market. The art world goes into shock as a Warlowski print goes up for sale for $400 million. Ooh, I bet Priscilla wants to buy that.
Yeah.
Honey, buy me that expensive piece of artwork, please. Okay, so Connie's like your inside trade dealer.
What she'll do is she'll give you 1 week kind of advance notice of something that's going to happen, so you get a little bit of an edge for $1,000. But so Boeing, we should buy Boeing.
Didn't Boeing went down in stock? They had to sell off like a whole bunch of stuff recently.
In real life, or this
in
game?
Real life,
probably.
Yeah.
It's called Boeing in this.
Boeing, okay.
So let's sell that.
Let's sell that crap.
Let's get rid of Carnival, which is Carnival Cruise Lines.
Yeah, that's the cruise line. That's the only stock that you have right now.
Yeah. The way I play is I just buy, like, I don't have multiple stocks. I just deal with one at a time, just hardcore it. Mm. So we want Boeing.
You got yourself a coffee?
Yep.
I got coffee. You only got me one cup of coffee?
Yep.
No. This music, man.
Interest rates, yeah, whatever. You just... blue chips, blah, 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 blah.
This is on the NES.
Yeah.
But I think this game was also on other systems as well.
I'm not sure.
Sure? Here, I'll look it up. I got a phone!
I know there's a Japanese version of this game.
Hey, Siri. Hey, Siri. Can you look up the Wikipedia page for The Wall Street Kid?
I like the British accent. It totally
well, ever sense. Since I changed it to a male British accent, he's been the laziest motherfucker on the face of the planet. I have to say, hey, Siri, twice. I was feeling lonely, and I wanted a male voice to be around me, so...
Hi, honey. I really love dogs. Can I please have one?
Oh, great. Do you have to buy her something?
Well,
look at us.
Well, if you promise to take good care of it, you know, we can go look for one tomorrow. Thanks, honey. I'll see you tomorrow. Where are you tonight? Oh, I'm with another boyfriend.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay, let's figure out what's stuff.
Okay, so this is, released by Soffel for the NES. It was originally released in Japan as the Money Game 2, Kabachu no Kissy. I'm not even saying that right. There was the first one. This is a sequel. Oh my gosh, so there's like another game, and it's a Japanese game, but it looks exactly the same, and the like exact same look, exact same feel, only the stories are different.
Yeah, the story's different, yeah. Okay, let's finish this week.
Oh, we get to look at puppies! Look, which one's the train?
I'd like to have a look at some dogs.
Oh my gosh!
We have a poodle for 1,000, a chihuahua for 500. We'll get them beef.
Neither!
He's gonna hit neither. He's so cute.
Oh, so we got. Okay, look at her password, guys!
Yeah, we're not using passwords. We're gonna just do this one shot.
Yeah, we're doing this like 1cc. No passwords, no continues.
I find the game's actually hard at the beginning, and it gets easier later.
Yeah, if you can get through the first month, you're good.
Yeah, the first month is the hardest, in my opinion.
A chipoodle.
Hello, this is Ralph.
In fact, the owner's a friend of yours, John Feld. Okay, John. I know you love the house. John said you were raving about it at his last party. The cost is exactly $1 million. Your present credit status doesn't show any acquired assets to be applied against a loan, so you'll have to have the cash up front. If you agree to buy now and end up not having enough money on Saturday, you'll lose the deal. Would you go for it? Okay, if the house is still for sale next week, we'll call you to see if you're ready to buy. How long did it take you to complete this game?
I did it in 4 stages.
In 4 stages?
Because you have to do like 4 months.
Yeah, okay.
So I did one at each, and each stage takes about half an hour.
Yeah, we can do this. We can do this in one sitting.
I'll start
Tony's like, I got crap I have to do this afternoon. I gotta like cut my lawn, walk the dog, wash my car.
AT&T, okay. I'm gonna buy some AT&T. But the good thing is like once you get started, you can just roll through the days really quickly.
Yeah. Like you said, the first month is probably like the hardest.
Yeah.
It's probably the hardest.
It is, because you have no loan or anything, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you got nothing. You have no assets. You have no collateral to fall back onto. It's like you're starting out. It's like straight out of high school. I got like no credit whatsoever.
Yeah, you're a nobody kid. You're not even on Wall Street.
Yeah, you're the nobody kid.
You're on the Toronto Stock Exchange.
That's what we're playing. We're on Bay Street.
That sounds like a wonderful idea.
Let's go out.
Okay, let's finish.
Check me out my new phone case.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. I don't know if you guys can see it, but my new cell phone case is, yes, it's a Master System. Are you liking this music so far? His music is sounding great. Yeah, I'm kind of a nerd.
So she says that.
Okay, so she's got that.
American Depressed.
Yeah, I'm gonna like totally find myself like the best boyfriend. I'd be like, you can give me a call on my Master System. Oh no, this is the Mega Drive. Give me a call. Give me a call, baby.
Okay, what did she say was good?
I wasn't paying attention. I was too much into my cell phone case. Chat, what did she say?
Hold on. Oh, no, I was going to look at the old video. She said something about AT&T.
Yeah, it was. It was AT&T. That was right, yeah.
Didn't I just buy AT&T? Okay, hold on. Let me just... I want to be sure. Another $1,000. Oh, fuck.
Maybe next time I'll have some info. It was AT&T.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Something
I'm pretty
about
sure.
Ringing, something about ringing sales. Whatever. It's still gonna do well.
Yeah, it better do well.
Okay, deal with Priscilla. She probably wants to go shopping. I wish I could.
She's gonna be going out with your other friends.
Let's do picnic.
Oh, she was going to picnic. Dude, we should go to the picnic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, totally. It's sometime, but the weather's nice.
But, like, you know how much, like, yeah, this, it was so hard, like, even do this.
I got 700,000. I'm getting there.
I love how I blame my father.
Oh, American Depress is what I wanted.
Oh!
That's fine.
Okay, we're still in this. We still got this.
I can still do it. It still went up, but it just not as much as I wanted. American Depress will still do okay for another week.
Better. This music's not that bad. It kind of grows on you a little bit.
It's stock market music.
Stock market. Whatever you're buying and selling your stocks and stuff, this is what goes in your head. Like when you're doing your financial planning, Tony, and you're like putting money into your RSPs, you're like, doo-doo-doo-doo.
So I'm going to talk to her again. That's a match. Pro tip is talking to this woman.
Yeah, it's just like always having... Why can't you just say Connie, man? Like, Connie knows where it's at.
Straight ham. Why straight
ham? Straight ham. Straight ham. May consider increasing its product line. Oh, so Techno asks, spending time with you... Because that's what Priscilla asks. But since this is a stock market game and time is money, does Priscilla actually mean spending money with you? I would say yes, because that's the kind of woman Priscilla is. Brilliant idea. Let's go shopping.
Why can't she go shopping with her friends? That's the password.
Okay, so we got a password now. That password, by the way, is one of the most bullshit passwords, like, ever invented. Ever in history. I like reading the wacky, oh, Ralph is calling us again. Larry just told me that you must purchase the house by May 1st. The house is still for sale, and I can take you by the house on Saturday to close the deal. So the first thing you gotta do is you gotta buy this house, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
There's no way to do this within the... Like, it's impossible to do this until, like, May 1st on the dot, because you need every penny.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Ralph. Okay, so, let's see what she has to say to it. Okay.
Centipede has plans to Surge building. They're going to get Surge, which is a drink. Have you ever had Surge before?
No.
No, I've never had Surge either.
That would give me a few more legs to stand on. Centipede. Okay, we gotta buy Centipede.
Ahaha. That's an awful joke.
Okay, let's sell.
Strayhound.
It's like Greyhound. Buy. I wonder if any company tried to sue this game. They
this
probably
game?
Didn't. Yeah.
No. I mean, like, they all use joke names, right?
Yeah.
And, like, it's just text, right? It's not like they're being misinterpreted or... Hot stocks bulletin, cash money. Local rock band hits Stone City again by storm. 3 days added to their sold-out concert. That one wasn't as funny.
Let's do hiking. Good decision. Hiking is very good for your health and state of mind. Transaction takes 8 hours.
The transaction. It's always a transaction. Higher prices. Oh, you're
keep
going
interest
to-
rates climbing.
Oh, you just watched the Surge commercial. My goodness.
Oh, maybe I think we need to get higher soon.
Surge! Gymnasium under investigation by health department. Uh-oh.
So that means you can't swim this week.
Okay. So that means somebody peed in the pool?
Yeah.
Okay. I love how it's just a big deal when someone pees in the
Prior.
Pool. Chrysler is releasing a new competitive price car. I don't feel that they'll be shedding any tears on this deal. Ha ha ha. That's awful. Oh, you just spilled coffee.
Yeah,
that's all right.
Lie. That's fine. So.
Boom.
It's buy and sell.
Yeah, Surge is kind of like a super sweet, like, energy drink kind of
well,
thing.
It's like Monster.
Like a Mountain Dew.
Oh.
Like, I've seen it. It's an American thing. Like, we're Canadian, so we don't,
we
yeah.
Like Coffee Crisp.
Coffee Crisp. I like Coffee Crisp.
Okay, let's move to the next day. So we're almost getting close to the million.
Okay, we gotta get $1 million. We're getting close. Like, in the first month, you gotta get $1 million?
Yeah.
And then what? You buy that house?
Yeah.
Okay.
But then you can get a loan.
If you have $1 million?
Well, okay. You have a house because you have equity then, right?
Oh, yeah, that's right. And then you can keep buying stocks because you have it. Okay. So we're showing you guys how to beat this game. Because there's a strategy. Total strategy.
More
to
giant cockroaches invade small South Seas Island. Giant cans of... Raid use.
Raid use without success. Haha.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
I hate when the phone rings. Oh, hi, honey.
My car is old and broken down. I need a new one. I'll go look at that tomorrow.
Thanks
honey.
Okay, let's...
Watch, like,
let's take her out carnival. That sounds good. Let's have a fun day. And then we'll buy a car.
And then we'll buy a car. Yay! Don't buy a car.
You don't have to buy a car.
Yeah, you don't have to buy her anything. That's the big secret to this game. She wants you to spend money, and you don't have to spend any money on your girlfriend. You can take her to look at stuff. Nice.
She'll be upset. Oh, she didn't do anything.
Yeah, she didn't get mad. She won't get mad if you look at stuff. If you just look at the crap, she won't get mad.
The dog, she gets upset about.
She will get upset about the dog. Who wouldn't get upset if you took and see puppies and you're like.
We can still win the game, it's just you have to go to the carnival more often with her.
Yeah.
Prior. Well, we have $1 million pretty much now, anyway, so.
Okay, good. Well, yeah, we're like $40,000 from like.
So.
Oh, who's calling this now? No, it's Ralph, okay. The house is still for sale. That's good. We're gonna buy it soon. Don't worry. No worries.
I'm interested. Good choice.
There we go. Sure. We're gonna get this house. Because this is where everybody dies. It's like they just don't get to buy the house because they don't make $1 million. And
hello again. Okay, I don't care about the info. Let's just make more money.
Let's make more money and get with it. Oh, that's good. That's good. I like that.
Okay, we're kicking ass now.
Okay, yeah, we're flying through this. We got $1 million already. Look at that. That's strategy right there.
What?
Huh?
What strategy?
The whole, like, you know, getting $1 million.
Yeah.
You know, telling your girlfriend to shut up.
Yeah, the car would have made her break the whole deal.
Yeah, that would have broken, like, the entire deal. Honey, I love you, but shut up.
Yeah, I need the house. Do you want the house or the car?
I want the house.
Okay, let's
the house has better collateral than the car any day of the week.
So what you want to do is you want to pull out your cash, because you need to get cash and pull that out. So
all
now
right.
I have $1,000,097.
All right.
So
it's Thursday. We got 2 days.
So I'm going to enjoy myself. So one day of hiking. Oh, shit.
You want a car? I want $1 million, so shh.
Good decision, working out. Good for your health. The transaction takes 4 hours. Okay, next day, I'm going to spend a day with Priscilla.
Hey, Lobo, what's up?
Wall Street, blah, 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 interest rates, blue chip speculative, blah, blah, blah. Xerox, Cryer, YBM,
YBM, I like that.
Tick abundance attacks, family out of King Crest.
There we go. Oh. It's like, yeah, ticks are a major problem. And
they're here, they're crazy here.
They're crazy here right now.
I had one on a tray on his ear.
Really?
I had to pull it out, yeah. And there was actually two of them there.
No!
Yeah.
If everyone wants to know, Atreo is Tony's dog. What kind of dog do you have? Tell him about your dog.
Golden Retriever, and he's awesome.
Yeah, Atreo's pretty cute.
He's a lap dog. Good morning. This is Ralph Vaughn. Just to make sure you're awake, I'll meet you at the house.
I'm glad you decided to buy this gorgeous house. Well, it's all yours. Thanks. Enjoy. Change of music.
Congratulations. They spelled it properly.
Yeah, they spelled it right. You have accomplished the first step of your new house. It's a decent beginning for a Benedict. Yes, name from the never-ending story. That's your dog. Thank you for the wedding invitation. I'll be there. The Benedict tradition is to honeymoon on a yacht. A decent yacht may cost around $700,000. You're going to have to get married on a friggin' boat, Tony. Just a reminder, please keep saving your money. Okay, so there we go.
Okay, so we're a quarter done the game, I believe.
Okay, we're one quarter through this.
Okay, so the first thing you want to do at this stage
Is
when you have $97,000.
Uh-huh.
Let's
is this going to be Ralph? Well, it's Doc.
Oh, this is Doc.
Yeah, he's the boat guy.
He told me we were interested in buying a yacht.
Of course we are, because you have to marry this girl on the boat.
So the trick is you only have $97,000 to move stock. So what you want to do is screw that and you go to this person.
Ruth,
how can I help you? I want a loan.
The bogus boat salesman.
Against a loan for $800,000 plus five. So you have to, there's interest on it, but the thing is
you're going to be making some coins, so you'll be able to pay this off, like, real fast, so go for it.
Okay, well, now we want to talk to her and just get some ideas. Yeah, give me some tips. Pan,
ma'am. Denied rumors. Domestic line cut-ups. I don't think there'll be any holes in this pan.
Let's buy some pan, ma'am.
Yo, do you have your tennis racket?
Not here.
Okay, crap. Okay, I'm just letting you know they're going to be starting construction soon of the park.
Okay.
We're getting a whole new tennis court.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. But I'm just telling you, I'll have to keep you updated on the progress of it.
Okay, cool.
Because we probably won't be able to go play tennis.
Okay.
Or we could go play tennis somewhere else. There's other places. There's other tennis rackets.
This is Milton.
This is Milton. I mean, like, there's another place. There's a really nice park that has a really good setup. I don't know if we need a key to get in there. The fence is really damn high, but we can get in there. Yeah, we all tennis. Like, my doctor's telling me I have to get, like, way more active. Like, I actually went out to, like, the house leagues for cricket.
Oh, wow.
I did. Cricket's and it was nothing but older men. It was nothing but, like, overweight older men. And I was like, well, yeah, no. I mean, I could have met, like, a whole bunch of new friends, but I was like, yeah, no, I don't want
to. American depressed, okay. It's okay if there's, like, one old man, but if there's, like, a group of old men,
it was just gonna be so slow. Like, cricket's kind of slow to begin with, and it would just, like, yeah, I don't know. What is it? Marty McFly is part of that volleyball group. He's in a house league volleyball group that's, like, around here, but... I'm actually okay at volleyball, but my problem is that, like, I like to play goofy, like, volleyball. Like, I use my head to smack the ball, like, a whole lot, and I don't know if people would be, like, for that or against that.
I got a Fitbit thing.
You got a Fitbit?
Yeah.
I want a Fitbit. I want the Apple Watch. I want all the Apple products. Did you hear I bought an iPad Pro? I don't have it yet.
Oh, okay.
I'm paying it in installments at work. That's the only way I can afford to get it.
Okay. What's the difference between that and the Pro?
Oh no, are we having, I think it's still, I just think it's your internet techno, because I'm still getting something. We're still going. We're still in this. The economy too, that's the other thing you have to watch, is the economy keeps going up and down at the same time.
Yeah. Mugger's becoming regular at the shopping mall. I've never been to the shopping mall while it has the Mugger thing. But I don't want to take my
chance. Can you get mugged?
I don't know.
I don't want to know either.
I don't want to lose my 57. Like, I can't risk it.
I can't risk it. We can't go shopping, Priscilla.
It might just say you're not going to go shopping, I think.
You know it'd be really awesome? If they, like, remade this game, but they made it, like, American Psycho Wall Street Kid?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that would be awesome. How come somebody hasn't done this yet? Because, like, really, that's pretty much what we're looking at here. Yeah. And they have the whole scene with the business card.
Oops, let's move the deck. You want to write that password out?
Yeah, I'm going to get out my, like, shitty piece of paper. Like, you're a kid and you're playing. Like, who would get this? Who would get this for their freaking kid? I know who would. I'm not going to say it. My dad would buy this game for me. Let's just say that. He's like, I want you to grow up to understand what money's all about. So I'm gonna get you this game, and you're gonna grow up, and you're gonna understand what the stock market's all about. Like, I remember when I got into, like, peer enrichment in school, we actually did have to play the stock market game, which was kind of, it was like a board game. It was like a total flat-out board game of the stock market. Oh my god, that was like 8 hours of my life I'm never gonna get back ever again.
Did you ever have those Unisys icons back in school? They were old, back in elementary school. The computers, the big box of computers, and there's like a keyboard and there's like a roll pad.
Oh yeah, no, I had that in high school, dude.
I was privileged.
I was actually privileged. Oh my god. Hey, it's Corbin's birthday. I won't say his age.
He's like, I think a year older than me.
Yeah. And it's Aaron's birthday. I love how all my alerts just came on. Have you talked to Corbin lately?
No.
Kaufman. It's a shame.
Kaufman Broad.
Coffin and broad. You're coffin and broad. Well, like, look what Corbin's missing out on. Corbin's totally missing out on the Wall Street Kid action. Nope. I should probably send, like, a happy birthday or something to him. Last time I talked to him, he was doing this sit-up challenge.
Oh, I think he was doing a push-up one.
Yeah, he was doing, like, a push-up or a sit-up challenge.
He did 1,000 of them.
Yeah.
But it took him about a week, I think. He was doing, I think, about 200 a day.
I love how we never talk to him, but we're so like, hey, look at your Facebook thing. You're doing this challenge. He's always posting up a challenge or something weird that he's doing.
He had this one video. He had a device that clipped on, and it was, I can't remember what it did.
Yeah.
He was trying to do, not like levitation, it was like this weird thing.
I like it when he actually shares the videos of him actually doing a project or something intense, as opposed to all of his photos of tossed out party girls on, like, mattresses in his living room. I know they're his friends, but still.
Okay, I haven't talked to Priscilla in a while.
Okay, talk to your girlfriend. Talk to your bae.
Let's have a fun day.
tiddlywinks. Man. Boop 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 doop boop boop doop doop boop boop doop doop.
Get some more tips.
When I tweeted this out, I tweeted out that it's torture time.
Yapple. Kids get some Yapple.
You have to get some Yapple stock. Man, I'm getting so many Yapple products lately. You see, it's funny because like I work at the Apple store, but it's an independent Apple store, so it's better than the actual Apple store. But to differentiate the fact that I don't work at the Apple store, I say I work at the Bapple store, which is a hell of a lot more hilarious.
Do they give you, like, in terms of pricing, is it the same?
I do get a discount, yeah, but I don't get a large discount.
But the prices that you guys sell at, is it like this? Like, say there's an iPhone 6S.
We don't sell the phones.
Oh, okay.
But we sell the computers and the iPads and everything. We're the same price as the Apple store.
Okay, so yeah, so that's good. Because if you're going to be an Apple authorized retailer, they have to keep the price, like, across the board. Because it's not fair for the Apple, like, your types of stores.
And that's one thing, too. It's like, when you're buying a computer, when, like, I don't know, like, buying, like, this is the way I remember buying a computer back when I was a kid and stuff. It was a huge deal. Like, you actually, you know, would have to go in and it was a decision and stuff. Like, nowadays, people just go into, like, box stores or Walmart or Best Buy and they buy this shit. And I'm like, you shouldn't be buying your computer at, like, Best Buy.
If you just want a computer.
Like, you really shouldn't. You don't know where that computer's been.
Yeah, I bought one at the big box store and I took it out and there's all this like gooey stuff on it and like who knows what where it's been.
Goo. Oh my god, the goo. Don't talk to me about the goo. Like, oh god, it's like if that's what it was. It probably was a display model and children were probably touching it. You don't know where children's hands have been, like seriously.
See, she wants a stereo.
Yeah. You know?
So his response is, that sounds like a good idea. Well, look, we'll go for a look tomorrow. But when it's something stupid, like, can I buy a dress? He's like, okay. So he's kind of cool about that, right?
He's cool about that, but whenever it's something that's for her, like, I like how you said it was dumb. Like, we have to go buy a dress. Okay, that's dumb, right? That stereo system? Okay,
yeah,
let's go,
like,
look
that's
at that.
That sounds like a good idea. Because he gets to use it, too, right?
I like that he has priorities.
Paradigm. Oh, okay. Don't buy that stock. Okay, we'll just hold on to what we have.
Go for a look. Window shopping again. Totally window shopping. Different music? Hey, dude. We're looking for a TV and stereo set for our new home. Oh, wait, you say it.
A Somi system for $6,000.
Holy crap.
And a Sony DAC for $3,000. Which one do you want, dude? Let's get the V1.
But that price, I hope it lasts a while. Thank you, honey!
Okay. Do you want to write that one down? There's question marks and percent signs.
Yeah,
like,
I know. Like, what the fuck? You were never going to write this password down. You want to know why? Because you're never going to play this piece of shit game ever again. Oh my gosh.
They could have made the code maybe 6 digits, because then it would still be... Like, you're not going to crack that code.
No, you're never going to crack it. So, like, why the F did you have to make your password so freaking long? Like, I know I sound like an angry...
I think the password holds all the data, like how much exactly cash and stocks and everything you have.
Yeah.
So that's why it had to be so long, but they could have worked around that.
They could have made it half the length. They didn't have to make it so it's like, you know, this has like, what's weird is that this game is like made for like the NES, but it totally has a feel that it should be played like on a PC,
yeah,
or a computer. Because, like, that password is, like, yeah, that wouldn't be so bad if you had a keyboard, right?
Yeah.
Just to kind of, like, tickety-tickety type it in.
Okay, so, like, we need to do something.
techno, that's funny.
Oh, no, that's okay. So we're gonna talk to the newspaper. What's going on?
We're gonna talk to the newspaper. Hello, newspaper, how are you today?
Okay, we want... Let's get American Depressed. I'm feeling good about that one.
Now that video of you in the car is going to make a hell of a lot more sense.
Okay, let's buy some American Depress.
You're doing good. It's like 9 a.m. What do you got to do today, dude?
I got to take my dad to the airport.
Okay, that's kind of important.
Yeah, you get to take your dad to the airport. Didn't you tell him that we were playing Wall Street Kid today? You're gonna be like, can't do it, Dad. Play Wall Street Kid. Priorities. God damn it, Dad.
Oh no.
Oh no?
Exercise. She's sad.
She's sad because you're not working out.
Yeah.
You're not as buff as you used to be, honey.
Okay. I need to really shape up. So first thing is I need to talk to her.
You need to talk to Connie. Hi. Marriott Hotels plan to build 10 hotels this year. Maybe they'll be merry.
She's really sassy, eh?
Yeah, she is kind of. If I can identify with any broad in this game, it'd be Connie.
I would totally have to hack this game, like make my own version that's exactly the same, but with like slight twists.
It's more swearing.
I would change the text a little bit.
No, if I could, it would be American Psycho, Wall Street Kid. And it would just be like clips from the movie intertwined with like the gameplay. I mean, that would just be smart to do a movie tie-in and get that cha-ching cashola. Even if the game's awful, we can cash in on it.
Time to check out.
You know what? I don't own that movie.
Which movie?
American Psycho.
Oh.
I don't own it on DVD or Blu-ray. It's not even part of my Apple stuffs. They made a sequel of it. I've never even seen the sequel. And apparently it's like exactly the same, but it's like a woman, but it's not like written by, the story is like not even written by Bret Easton Ellis.
Prince.
Yeah, there would definitely be a cocaine variable.
Yeah. There's got to be like a cocaine thing.
There's got to be a scene where your railing lines blow off of like some hookers.
Like,
this
should be Wall Street. What's that movie? The Wolf of Wall Street Kid.
That'd be your movie.
And like, there's things like you go to Connie and there's like investment tip.
Yeah.
And then it's like, give blow or like, give her like $1,000 just for the hell of it, just to like, whatever.
Buy a prostitute.
Yeah. What was I going to do?
Casino Kid? I do not have Casino Kid. I don't even know. Are they related?
No. Is it the same kind of game?
I'm going to have to look this up. Where's my phone? Where's my Mega Drive? I don't want to ask Siri, though. Siri's being a pain in the butt. I think I want to change Siri back to being a lady again. Look at that birdie! Sorry, I'm looking at cute bird videos. Look at him.
Oh my god.
That was cute!
Okay, we need to get Rattel.
Canadian Psycho. Give Connie. Yeah. Too soon, Connie, I'm sorry. And, yeah, that was funny.
Okay, we need to make. Okay, we need to work out more. Okay, I need to deal with Priscilla next week or tomorrow.
So I'm actually gonna look up the publisher. And they should have like, yeah, they did do Casino Kids. Okay, so the same publisher did do Casino Kid. So that would be interesting. We should go to the Toy Rat, buy Casino Kid, take it back, and see if it parallels or how it fares or shapes up to Wall Street Kid. Oh wow, Softbell Co. Limited is a Japanese information technology company involved with business application systems development, multimedia service and system development, and the development of RFID services and systems. It was established in May 1979 to provide software such as comps to their major clients. Very briefly involved with video games in the late 1980s and early 1990s. So it was basically like this huge, like where they build business software. This makes sense. You're taking your shopping again? I think you take your girl shopping far too much.
Well, it's Priscilla.
Where are we? Are we at the museum? Oh, we're at the art museum. Okay, look at this fantastic art that we can buy.
We're interested in purchasing a painting.
Oh, that's great.
Well, we have the AnnK for $50,000. Let's get the cheaper one.
That's good. Don't buy an AnnK. You can't afford it.
It's nice enough. Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah. Here's your password. Write it down, kids. Get your big sheet of paper and your big pencils. Your number 2B pencils.
Okay, we need to really...
You need to do this. You need to bring it. What? Cat's being... What? Okay, so Sawfell apparently did a Game Boy game called Fish Dude. Okay, I'm so on that. I am on that. Fishing games, I'm there. I'm looking that up. Shit. Do, 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 do. Okay, I gotta look this game up. Fish Dude. Can I type?
Choir, let's get some choir.
Wow, the Wikipedia entry for that is, like, no good. This dude. Do-do-do-do. There we go. Fish Dude for Game Boy. It's an action game. Okay, I'm gonna have to look that up later. Cheaper Fish Dude cart. Oh my god. It's not a fishing game though. Yeah, but I'm very interested. It looks like a fishing game, but it's not a fishing game. Okay, I'm gonna leave that up so I can go raid that later because I'm actually very interested. Let's reload that. Do 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 boo. Rebucks. I like the Rebucks. Do do do. You having fun, Tony?
Yeah, as long as I make this month, I'm happy.
Yeah, you gotta make this month. You eat the fish and grow bigger while avoiding bigger fish until you're big enough to eat those bigger fish. I have no problem with that fishing game. I like all kinds of fishing games. You know, that sounds like another game that I would play with my old roommate, with Justin, where you'd have to eat fish and get bigger and stuff. Come on, Tony, you can do it. How much money do you need to get?
800, 700,000. But the thing is, I have a loan, though.
Yeah, you have a loan. That's
fine.
So
I've got to pay it back.
You got to pay it back by a certain time?
Yeah. This week.
This week?
What week are we on?
I don't even know. Check your calendar. Because you can't go back. We haven't been saving. We haven't been doing anything.
Thursday. Okay, I'm going to pay it off now, just get it out of the way, and then I'll see how much I have, because then I'll feel better.
Yeah, because like I think, what's the next thing you have to buy? The yacht?
Yes.
And when do you have to get the yacht?
Well, this is the yacht one. The next is, I think... something else.
And the yacht is 700,000. It's not as bad.
Loan payment.
Yeah, but you could just get another loan after you pay off this loan,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
there you go.
So you don't have enough. Oh, yeah. Okay, shit. I gotta sell my shit. Hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Like, in the real world, you know, I'm a day trader, and there's times where I want to buy a yacht, and they're like, where's the cash? And I'm like, oh, shit.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, I got to sell my stock. Give me 5 minutes. Okay, now I can buy it. Happens all the time. Would you like to pay off your loan? Yes.
Yeah, perfect.
Oh, we're good. So I'm already 100.
Oh, yeah, we awesome. We end this.
Yeah, we're good. Unless Priscilla wants something.
Okay, just tell her to shut up. Shut up already.
Okay. Spray Hound. Okay, okay, buy Spray
One
Hound.
Second. I need to make more coffee because we're already out of coffee, so.
I'm out of coffee. I need to make coffee. What? What do you want? You can eat anytime you want to eat. Oh man, it's gonna be the Garfield mug today.
Picnic! Hello, this is Doc. I just wanted to remind you not to forget the $700,000 cash.
Don't forget! Pay your bills!
And you have to sell your stock to get that, eh? So you gotta...
Totally.
Because you can't just...
I'm just gonna reach in my pocket and pay ya.
Okay, so I have 861 cash, and I'm gonna do a day of hiking. So Priscilla thinks I got a hot bod. Oh, hiking trail's closed, shit. Okay, I'm gonna go gym workout. Good decision. Working out is very good for your health. Transaction takes 4 hours. Okay, cool. Or you know what? I can still take her on a picnic. That sounds like a great idea.
That sounds like a great idea.
Okay, we're good. Let's buy that fucking yacht. Sorry. Good morning. This is Doc. Just calling to make sure you're awake. I'll meet you at the harbor. I know you're gonna love this yacht. Thank you. Have a wonderful honeymoon.
Yay! Yay! Okay. I see you bought a beautiful yacht. What an accomplishment. I just found out that the castle will be for sale at an auction. I'll keep you informed of everything else I learn about it. There we go. We're gonna do this. We're gonna get that castle. We're gonna be rich, baby.
Memorial Day. So what am I supposed to buy now? I just make money?
Yeah, just make a hell of a lot of money, man. Just bring that bank in. Bring it on home, Tony. You're like halfway there.
Bethlehem Steel. Okay.
Music. Dude, okay, so I was watching one of my friends stream the other day and he was playing Princess Maker 2.
Princess Maker 2?
Yes, you totally gotta play this game, man. It's seriously, it's legit. I wanna play. It's like, that should be like another game that you and I play because it's totally up there in that whole strategy market. Here, can you hold on to that for a sec?
Is that hot?
Yeah, it's hot. Yeah!
That's the only way to get on the couch. I'm so happy I have a couch now. Dude, I fell asleep on the couch the other day. Friday night, passed out on this.
I'm gonna take out for carnival.
Can think about the heating bills when you buy a castle. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Oh man, this is like a pretty good early morning like stream. Like people are probably like waking up on Sunday saying, I'm not gonna go to church.
Oh, okay.
No, Michelle wants to go early to antiquing. She doesn't understand that Sundays I play video games. I should get Michelle over here. We should play real estate sim. Is there a real estate simulator out there? Like, this is the worst Garfield mug on the face of the planet. I don't know if you guys can see this. Okay, this is my Garfield mug. It's a Halloween one, but you can't tell that it's Halloween. It just looks like Garfield has two heads with a bag, and he's gonna throw up in this bag because this mug is awful.
Tomorrow's the big day.
Are we getting married?
Yeah.
Oh, sweet!
On
Dude,
the yacht.
We did this, like, so fast. I didn't think it was going to be this fast.
Yeah,
it's like
right.
1 hour.
We still got to get the castle, though.
Yeah, we got to get the castle, okay. We got the girl. We got the boat. We got the house. We just need to get the castle.
Getting married.
Oh my god! And there's no wedding music or anything. It's just the same awful music playing at your wedding. I'm going to do that. When you, like, get married, like, you know, when you're, like, standing there, I'm going to play Wall Street Kid music. Yeah. And you're going to be like, I hate you, Anne.
So what I did is I changed the word Benedict and I put Del Vecchio in there.
Nice. That'll be your wedding invite.
On July 1st.
Yeah, Priscilla does have a nice wedding ass.
Please keep in mind that maintaining Benedict's
wedding transaction took 8 hours.
Yeah, that's exactly.
If it's anything like, you know, what most weddings are, wedding transaction took 12 hours. Yeah. Freaking bullshit. Aww. Yay! Look at those. You're on a honeymoon on a boat. Hi, Steelnet. How's it going? Happy honeymooners! This is great because, like, you know, most people would never actually see past the first month of this
game.
Yeah,
they would have given up.
You would have given up.
I'm not saying I'm speedrunning this game, but I'm
You're
going,
totally speedrunning this game.
Getting
You're getting through this pretty damn fast. We should have had, like, a counter, a timer in the corner right there going off.
Imagine I have, like, a counter, and I make one bad move, like, on the third month. I'm like, hit the reset. Go, no, it was 4 seconds.
That'd
I'd
be great.
Shoot yourself.
That'd be great. Everyone's like, oh, I see everyone leave. Oh,
I should have bought that other stock instead of the other one.
Damn it. Reset.
It's okay to reset, like.
Dude, we should totally, like, try to speedrun this, and then we can go to, like, AGDQ and be like, guys, you want to see the Wall Street Kid dump real fast? This is any percent, so. He didn't buy max stocks and missed one.
Dude, yeah, don't
People are interested in how fast you can play this game. Like, we're going pretty, we're playing this pretty legit right now, so. Probably. Tweet that out.
Carnivore. Okay, we gotta get some carnivore.
No, Michelle, no. No. 7 a.m.? No.
Kid, I need to... Not neglect the wife.
Don't really clear now, she's your wife. You can't neglect her.
And then I need to work out so I look still good for her. Because she'll just leave. Okay, boom, next day. Let's go hiking. Get super buff. Transaction takes 8 hours.
Any percent. Yeah, there's no coke or mistresses in this game, Steelnet, even though there should be.
Okay, Priscilla. Michael Carnival.
Can you have a baby in this game? Is there, no, there's no baby element. You guys are just rich bastards that just want to make filthy money and spend it.
If they had a baby option, it would be the worst because it would just cost you so much.
It would just cost you so much.
Like, let's have a baby. It's like,
did
no.
You guys have that conversation? That awful conversation?
Yeah.
Ugh. How'd that go?
No, it's fine. We don't
it's
want
fine?
Any.
We don't want any? High fives.
Yeah. We said if there's an accident, then we'll be okay. Like,
okay,
if
there's an accident, you'll be okay with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, we both said like if there's that, then...
Yeah, everyone's making the Wolf of Wall Street NES jokes.
Maybe so cool to like go to Connie and like have like a hey, let's just like here's you know.
Let's have an affair and stuff, and then like we have to talk to Connie, where you have to give her like $50,000 to get an abortion because like you know you kind of messed up.
Yeah, just like crazy shit, and then you go to Ruth, and then you do the same shit to Ruth.
Yeah, if you could just do that, you could just be an absolute asshole.
Just be like a man whore.
We had a kid of Wall Street. Oh my god, chat! I love you.
Let's have a housewarming party.
It got real. This game got real.
Let's see how much it is first.
You were in accident, but it's okay. Smiley face. My parents told me that all the time when I was a kid. It didn't work me at all. A simple party. She wants to have a housewarming party. This is where you buy the Coke, right?
Oh, thank you, honey. We'll all have a lot of fun.
Oh, man.
Here's the code.
There's that password that we're just going to bypass because we're totally speedrunning this game now.
Okay. Interest rates, yes.
Your parents straight up told you that you were unplanned, quote unquote. Yeah, I was a quote unquote surprise. That's nothing. When my father was born, not only was he told he was a quote unquote surprise, he was so much of a surprise that his parents told him that they almost put him up for adoption.
Wow.
My dad was born in 1944. Times were rough back then. Like, you know, they didn't care. They'd sell children. You know, man, it's like, does that boggle your mind that, like, they used to be able to sell children in, you know, North America up to a certain point? Like, in your parents' age, like, they were selling children in this country.
Wow.
Look how far we've come.
Wicked.
Selling children? Yeah, you'd sell them into work. You'd make them work. Like a slave. Highest bidder wins the baby.
Auction would be cool.
An auction? This auction off like your unwanted children?
Yeah.
Dude, okay, so we, I was out with one of my clients yesterday taking pictures, and we went to this carnival, and, like, she kept bumping into all of her friends when she was there, right? And, seriously, she bumped into five, like, she bumped into more, right? But, like, out of, like, the eight or nine, you know, girls or women that she bumped into, five of them said they were going through a divorce.
So, out of how many?
Out of nine?
Five are going through a divorce. So a divorce is a certain...
They're all married. All these women are married women. This is all like the married mommy group thing that's in town.
Yeah.
And like more than half are all going through a divorce right now in this town.
You know what the crazy thing is? A divorce, like your life is this long.
Yeah.
This long. And a divorce is like a little sliver of your life. But it's really crazy how there's five out of nine that are in that little sliver of...
No, there's more. There's more. Like, you know, you remember how I used to be like a family photographer and stuff?
Yeah.
I would say like about 65% of all those people that I used to take all those happy family photos of, divorced or going through some kind of torrid affair or... Like, because I see them now at the Apple store, right? And all the women come in and they're like, how do I hide my text messages from them? And I just stare at them and I'm like, seriously, we're having this conversation. Like, I love how I was like once a part of your life and I was once part of your life in a very different time. And now I'm in your life again in a very dark time. But like, man, it's insane. Yeah, it's just really, really obscene and insane how the divorce rate in this community.
Yeah, Milton's a really bad community for divorcing because it's like really high because I think there's just so many elements of Milton. But I'm just wondering what the actual like
statistic is.
Yeah, but also the reason, like what, like out of those five, is it the same story or is it like?
I don't want to know. I'm not in that scene. I made this decision that I'm not going to get married, and it's like because I'm not going to get married, I'm going to try my hardest not to have children, right?
Yeah.
So it's like. Things might change down the road, but like, you know, I was like one of these people who's like, I'm not going to get married right when I turn 20 because I knew so many girls in this area that were like, the second they turned 20, 21, they were like, I want to get married and have a baby.
Yeah.
And that was their goals. They didn't care. Right.
Because, like, they had somebody that was telling them, you want to have a baby before you're 25. And I think it was that whole, like, pressure to actually have children and have children early on that, like, a lot of girls I knew, like, did that. And now they're going through some kind of, like, twisted divorce because they just found some guy off the internet or met somebody and...
Right.
Wow, okay, yeah. Both of those things. Second kid. Oh, wow. Okay, wow. Yeah, like, these are all the wrong reasons. Like, we're getting into this cool conversation now. Your high school friend was married before 20, divorced again, and then remarried the first guy. Wow. Yeah, that's pretty much, like, the same story I'm picking up around here, so.
What's the story?
Oh, okay, so he's, like, his high school friend got married before 20,
yep.
Divorced, married again. Divorced again, and then remarried the first guy.
They went back and married the first person?
Yeah.
That should be illegal.
That should, like,
should
be illegal.
Seriously.
Seriously, that should be illegal.
Like, if I were a priest or whatever, I wouldn't, like, I'd be like, no.
No.
But if I was one of those, like, those Leisure Suit Larry, like, quickie things.
Yeah,
it's like,
quickie wed.
As long as there's a money, then I don't care. I'm like,
yeah.
Whatever. Like, you could get married 20 times. It's just... It's money to me.
You can get married all the time. It's
yeah.
Just, yeah.
Once a week, man, please. It's money. Oh, I was going to buy something Centipede, I think.
Yeah.
Well, I really need to make sure I'm at Wall Street. I remember when I was in... Centipede is what I want.
Yeah.
I was in high school, and college. And I think it was like 18 or whatever. And within the first week or two, this guy that I knew, I met there. Met this girl there,
uh-huh.
Like in college, and they were only together for like 2 weeks, or like it felt like 2 weeks or a month, and they were like super inseparable, and like every time they had like a second of privacy, they were like copping feels like everywhere.
It was a very intense,
like total,
yeah.
Like honeymoon heart, like, and then they got like, and then they got married like a month later. I went.
Wow.
I didn't go to the.
Yeah, of course you didn't go.
I didn't go to the wedding, but there was even my other friend. He hung out with his friend, which is the guy that got married.
Yeah.
And they were there, and he's like, "Oh, my wife or girlfriend's stopping over, like, can, whatever." And then he's like, "Okay, cool." So what ended up happening is he sat down, and like she sat here, and then he sat there, and they were like feeling each other on top. Like, well, he's there, so like he just felt so awkward because he's like,
kind of awkward.
Like. If you wanted me to be in this, you should have given me, like, a heads up so I could psychologically say yes or no and agree or disagree to this, because it really sounded like they wanted him in on the deal.
The right answer, the right response to why you're not married yet is that you haven't met the right person to marry.
Yeah.
That's the only proper answer to that
yeah.
question. If your parents are on your back about why you're not married, it's because you haven't met somebody yet that you want to marry. You don't marry someone just for the fact that you have to marry somebody
yeah.
or that you have to have kids or you have to do something. Oh man, she's buying a dress.
Well, I can design a dress with a bit of jewelry for $20,000. A simple dress for $10,000. Let's do me.
Neither. You don't need a dress.
So
you can just wear this paper bag.
So yeah, they met. Within 3 weeks, they were already, like, getting married. Like, within 2 months, they were married. And they were super, like I said, super inseparable. Like, super, like, it's one of those, like, where are they going? Oh, they're going to the bathroom to, like, go at it. Like, they were totally, like, their whole relationship was purely sexual. And then, like, a month after that, they crashed and burned really hard. They were just like, I don't want to see your fucking face again.
Oh, wow,
like,
it got crazy.
It was like this.
Something happened. Somebody cheated on somebody. That's usually what happens in, like, those really heated, like, you know.
Like, they were, like, people we were all, like, because there was a whole clique of us.
I knew a bunch of people who had, like, who got in relationships. Like, it was purely just, like, a sexual relationship.
Yeah.
And, like, those ones always, like, if you base your relationship strictly just on sex.
It
right?
was, that was it. Well, that
it
was...
usually crashes and burns. It's, like, it's always about passion. And if it's about passion, it's going to, like, blow up in flames and just crash. It's going to be, like, crazy if it actually does that way. It doesn't always, all the time. But, like, what usually happens is that, like, either one partner or one person feels like, you know, they're getting tired of being in something like that. They want to get something a little bit different. Or the other person cheats on them or, like, wants, like, something else that the other person can't sexually do or something in the relationship. And so one of them starts to cheat, and then it just turns into this awful, like...
Yeah, it could have been both. It could have been, like, whatever. But, I mean...
Their beloved stock market crashed.
Transaction took 8 hours.
Yeah. The transaction took, like, less than 4 hours, but... Yeah.
But, like, it was one of those, like, I saw them, and I'm like, well, it's nice that they have this relationship together, but I would have just, like, if I could have given them advice, I would have just said, like, don't get married, don't do anything, just use each other for as much as you need, and then,
just,
what,
yeah.
And then when you both or one decides, like, okay, I'm looking for more now, you, like, it's still bitter, but
it's
not,
just, like, don't get married,
Like, I'm like, why did you get married if it's just that? Because I don't think they had anything other than that, like...
Well, yeah, that's the other thing, too. When you're young, you make a lot of, like, stupid decisions.
And I think she was younger, too, because he was, like, my age, like, 18 or whatever. And she was, like, one of those smarties that, like, skipped a grade or two. So she was, like, 17 or some shit.
Yeah.
I'm like, why are you, like, doing this so soon?
Yeah, no. Yeah, just don't get married.
Okay, what was I going to do?
Like, I know, like, some of the best relationships I know with people is, like, you know, they met, they got together. They moved in together. They got a dog. They did everything first. They actually had kids. And as soon as, like, the kid came around, they were like, okay, I guess we're going to get married.
Yeah.
Right? Those are some of the best relationships I know. Like, marriage came as, like, an afterthought of the fact that, like, okay, now that all of our assets are tied in together and, like, you know, I trust you and, like, we have a kid and we have a house. Like, sure, let's just get married and make our parents happy because, like... That's pretty much, like, why you get married. It's just to appease your parents or something.
Yeah, that's how I feel.
Your mom is all like, Tony, when are you going to get married?
You're a disappointment to my family.
Oh my god, I had to listen to my father. He's like, oh, who's going to take care of you? And the face I make when my dad, like, uses the who's going to take care of you sort of thing. I'm just like, I take care of myself, Dad. Screw off. Like, he's just thinking about me, like, when I get to be, like, 60 or 70. He actually thinks I'm going to be 60. I'm like, hell no. But if I actually do, it's not gonna suck. It's not going to be bad. Tony's mom's gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
Or
Steelnet says, like, one of the best couples I know are together for nearly a decade before they got married and they still don't have kids. Like, how long have you and Morella been together?
Almost 10 years,
yeah. And you're finally getting married after all this just to make your mom happy. Make your mom happy, make her mom happy. Here you go. No, I'm not.
I remember years ago when I was still living at home, my brother came over for the weekend, and just out of nowhere he brought this Polish girl over, and she showed up and she went up to me. She's like, hi, my name is, like, whatever, like, Monica or whatever her name is. And so I'm like, hi, I'm Anthony. She's like...
Tony Apokolovich or something.
And she's like, are you married? I'm like, no. And then she's just like, okay, well, how much, like, what kind of job do you make? She's asking questions like, how much do you make? Do you have kids? Do you have this?
Wow.
I'm like, I just met you, like, 30 seconds ago. And then she starts fucking vacuuming my parents' place and starts, like, doing dishes and cooks things.
Oh, someone wants to get married.
And she was asking my mom probing questions to, like, whoever. Like, and she was like, I want a tour of this house. She wanted a tour of the house. And then she went,
auctions tomorrow. We have to get at least 1 million. Yeah, we got 1 million. We got 1 million in cash.
Okay, we'll just work out.
We're gonna do this. Yeah, that girl was just looking. The fact that she was dating your brother.
No, they weren't. They weren't dating. They were just like, it was just.
She wanted to date him, right?
Yeah.
And he was like, ha, 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 "Silly girl." I like your brother's stories.
And then the what ended up happening was, oh yeah, she went to my parents' bedroom. She's like, oh, I can really see myself in this house, like in this bed.
That's creepy.
And my mom's like, get out. And she's like, get. And then like, get out of my house. And then like, my mom ringed my brother. I'm like, who's this girl? This like,
who's this freaking Polish girl you're bringing in here? Oh my gosh.
Oh, sorry. I hear 2 million.
We don't have 2 million.
The current bid is
$2 million, and I hear 2,005,000. Oh no.
You have to just let it go,
okay.
Just wait. Okay. The current bid is 2,400.
Okay, it's coming down now.
So then I put in 2,500.
You don't even have that much money.
No, this is like I get this for the month.
Oh, sweet! We got the castle! Bam!
Okay. 2 million now. 2.5.
10% deposit. Okay, so that's cool. Congratulations! You won the castle back! Now all you have to do is pay off the balance within 4 weeks. You're so close to carrying out the Benedict legacy and inheriting the fortune! Good luck!
We're at the home stretch now.
We're gonna do this.
1 month more to go.
Tier is on, guys.
Okay, so what we need to do... Oh, who cares about the economy right now?
The economy sucks right now.
Food chips, blah, 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 blah.
LOL, 4 weeks. We gotta pay off a castle in 4 weeks? That's insanity.
Hello, this is Ruth at the bank. I'm just calling to remind you that you must pay off the balance on the
castle. No later than Friday, July 28th. That's coming up, too.
Okay.
Get it all on black.
Okay, I need a loan.
Better get the extortion.
Okay, let's seriously make some cash.
I gotta make some coin, yo.
Yeah, let's listen to Connie. Let's do some coke first and then give me some tips. Yeah, let's get the tips.
Chrysler is showing a 25% profit increase. Okay, let's do this.
Let's buy some Kreider.
Oh, you got a relevant video clip? Okay, I'm gonna have to watch the video clip. I'm gonna have to watch a video clip after. It's kind of hard to watch video clips in the midst of Wall Street kidding.
Kidding!
But everybody else in the chat can go watch it. Getting copied out.
Independence Day.
See, this is great. I love your stories about, like, you know, how your family would bring home different people and how your parents would get, like, super upset at, like, your siblings and stuff for bringing home that trash or, you know, that obsessive, like, somewhat. My brother would never bring home dates, right? Because, like, it's my brother.
I remember one time I was in the basement and I was just hanging out, and then I was like late. I'm like 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, I'm going to bed. So I went upstairs and went to bed, and all I heard here out the window was just like laughing and giggling, and like, wait, you know, I guess my brother invited some people over and we're in the hot tub, like
having a good time.
Having a good
everything
time.
Is hot tub
and
party.
I'm just like, okay, whatever. So then it was like 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. I woke up, went downstairs in the basement. And, like, on the couch, there was a girl completely, like, just passed out, like, naked, like, just, like, there.
Oh, yeah,
like,
this story.
And I just walked in, and I'm like, I walked in, and I'm like, whoop, walked out. And my eyes were just like. And then I go up.
Is this the girl that you guys had to roll up in the blanket or something, or?
I can't remember that part.
Keep going with your story.
And then I went outside and talked to my brother's friend, and he's like, yeah, you know, like, he explained everything, like, they were in the hot tub, and she realized that we had a bottle of Jack Daniels, and polished it off, and she just finished it, and I'm
she took a bath of Jack. And
I remember the one person he was saying to me, goes, yeah, like, I took her in the bathroom and we were gonna have sex, right? And I'm like, so did you? He goes, like, no. I'm like, well, do you know where she's been before? And he's like, good point. Like, he was totally like, oh, we were so, like, I was so
I
gonna,
was so close.
I was so close, but then she, like, passed out on me or whatever because she was just too drunk. And I'm like, did you ever think of, like, you know,
where she's been before?
And
where
then,
did you find this girl?
And,
like, what's her name? What's her last name? Did you put these two things together?
And then,
I love your brother's story.
My brother's friend was like, yeah, this, like, it's funny because it seemed like his whole world came crashing down when I gave him the reality of, like...
The reality
like,
of, like,
you know,
sleeping
what,
with complete strangers
like,
is probably
know,
not a cool
yeah.
idea.
And then she woke up, and then she, like, well, obviously put clothes on and stuff. And I thought she was going to be, like, a normal girl. Just, like, normal, like, hey, guys. You
Hi,
know,
everybody.
Hi, everybody. Sorry about whatever. No, she had a filthy fucking mouth. She was, like, a person you, like, you don't bring to mom. Like, I'm, like, I don't know who raised her, but she was just, like, first thing was, like, cigarette. And then she's, like, what the fuck in this? And the fuck, oh, my God. And, you know, like, just.
Oh, man, like, so you totally saved your brother's friend from making a huge, disastrous mistake, right?
Yeah, she just seemed like one of those, like, trashy... I can't remember what she said, but...
Where did he meet this girl?
Oh, some bar.
Some bar? Okay, so you went to the bar, invited girls back to the hot tub.
Yeah.
I can see where this is going.
And then somebody said Jack Daniels, and she's like, Jack Daniels? And she fucking polished off the bottle.
Oh my God, awful.
No, it's just, she had a filthy mouth, like, just, like, really...
What bar? And, like, I don't even want to
know. I don't know.
It's Burlington. There's probably, like, a couple of, like,
this was so long ago, yeah.
Oh, man.
So what's the day? 10th. Okay. Hello again. So, Connie, help me out.
Yeah. A defect was found in the Boeing planes. I think you can consider its investment. There you go.
Don't buy
Boeing.
Okay, well, let's get some ideas.
Is her name Kesha? No, I don't think so.
Let's get Crier.
Let's get some Crier.
I always feel good with them. Okay, Jerry Springer. So, do you know the type of people Jerry Springer brings? Like,
yeah.
Just like the trashy women and men that just, they swear
she
all
the time.
She's
like a Jerry Springer type style.
And just... She was like just a piece of shit trash type of like.
Yeah, and it was like really good. You gave that pep talk that was like, maybe you're gonna get yourself into some kind of trouble. I mean, you don't know where she's been.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, if it only takes a bottle of Jack Daniels, I mean.
Like, yeah, exactly.
Like, so, anybody could go buy
she's
that.
She's lightweight. In Anne's books, an entire bottle of Jack.
Oh, and I think what ended up happening was when she woke up, she was like going back to the liquor cabinet again for more booze or something. Like, I'm just like, you got a serious problem. Like, total. Like, she was just like, I want more. I'm like, you just woke up from like being completely like inebriated, and you like, first thing is you go straight to the Jack Daniels.
That's
again.
My kind of woman. That's a girl you marry.
No.
No.
Hi. Give me some good tips.
Give me a good tip.
Okay.
Friedman's Fund has shown a profit increase. Okay, so now you gotta buy that one. The Misadventures of Dating. Better put a ring on it.
Friedman's.
Okay, so how much money do we have to get? The castle was...
$2.5 million.
Oh, we're still there!
I have a loan still that I have to pay off because I took a loan on it.
I know, but how much is a loan? 2.5?
No, I need to... First of all, I need to work out.
Okay, we'll work out.
So, I need $2.5 million, but I have $800,000.
Techno says, better put a lock on that liquor cabinet. Money better spent than a ring. Sorry, you were saying?
I need about $3
million. $3
million?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to do fine. You're going to get that.
Yeah, I'm just going
to... Now we're just riding the wave right now. You're just coasting it out. Yeah. Like, okay, the lock on the liquor cabinet. That reminds me of my friend Darren when we were growing up as a kid. And his big thing was stealing his parents' liquor.
Yeah.
Right?
And he would always pour it into other... See, that was the thing. When we were kids, it was raiding your parents' liquor cabinet and pouring it into, like, your own bottles and stuff like that to take it to the party. Or, you know, because, like, when I was a kid, no one would show up with glass bottles because that was total heat score, right? Like, you see, like, this is the reason why I don't like police. It's because, like, I would be walking back from, like, a study group. I would get stopped by a police officer, and they're like, open up your bag. And I'm just like, you have no right just to shout at me and, like, open up my bag. I don't have booze. I don't have anything in it. Like, you know, and I was actually really fortunate that 9 times out of 10, when I would get stopped by a police officer, there would not be booze or, like, yeah, I'd just be, like, actually having, like, you know, like, actual school stuff to do, right? But, like, yeah, you would, like, steal your parents' liquor by pouring it into, like, you know, another water bottle or, like, a shampoo bottle. Shampoo bottle was, like, the most... I remember,
it's
like...
soapy taste.
Yeah, because he'd come over to, like, the party and stuff, and he'd have the shampoo bottle, and he'd be like, okay, I got some vodka. And you'd be drinking it, and you're like, this tastes like pears.
It tastes like hands, shoulders, knees, and toes.
Oh, man.
It's like St. Ives.
Yeah, it's like that. It's totally like that. But, like, he would, like, not... Oh, what is he says? What party? Look at your party! Look at your party! It's so
I agree.
Cute.
Wanna dance?
Sure.
Oh, my gosh.
After you, dear.
After you. She's gonna, like, boogaloo, and then there you go. You get a password. Oh, man. Okay, then what happens? Yeah, so what he would do is that he'd take water... And he'd water down his parents' liquor. So they would know, right? So they would not be the wiser. So he'd actually would keep, he'd pour it out and see how much, like, was in there. And then he'd pour water in there. And it was getting to the point that he was just watering down and watering down and watering down, like, all this booze that was in his parents' place. So the fact that it was, like, it was pretty much just, like, water at the end of the...
I remember when I was young, I used to go to, when I go to hotels, mm-hmm. I'd open up the liquor thing.
Yeah.
Xerox profit, okay. And then they'd have those little vodka things, and I'd open it up and, like, fill it with water.
Yeah.
You wouldn't do it at the crazy hotels, because they have, like, sensors and stuff.
Yeah,
that
would actually
But
know.
If you go to, like, you know, Bill's, like, motel, and they happen to have one, it's like...
water down that free booze mahal.
Monday. Oh, yeah, I need Xerox.
Xerox.
I like how they give you up to, like, 999,000 stock. That never happens in this game.
Nah.
You don't go more than double digit.
Nah.
I don't know why they did that. Priscilla, let's hang out. Shopping.
The brilliant idea. Do, 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 do,
I think we'll make it.
Oh, I'm not going to send a message to her now, but, like, I'm going to tell Michelle, like, I can't do anything on Sundays until after 12 o'clock because this is when I play my games.
Okay, we're getting there. So I think about 15 minutes in this game is in the bag.
That's not bad. That's a good time. Like, we started playing this at, like, 8:30, and it's, like, been an hour so far. It's been over an hour, actually, if it's like, almost 10. So it's been an hour and a half. I actually own the 7th Guest. I actually have that for Super Nintendo, but I've never played it.
They made a 7th Guest for Super Nintendo?
Wait, yeah.
The 7th Guest?
Yeah.
Isn't that kind of house game...
Oh, no, I'm thinking about 7th Sega. That's what I'm thinking of. I was getting confused.
I'm like, 7th Guest? That was like a CD-ROM game.
Yeah, I got this one, the Enix game.
Oh.
I think this is the one... Which one's this one? Is this the one where you have the dog? I forget. I've never played it. I have it in my collection, though.
Okay, so I'm gonna...
So many of the same... Of, like, all these RPGs. Okay, can we go get...
Okay, I want to pay him.
Yeah, 7th Guest. That's
pay auction. Let's pay the auction. Oh, if I do that, I win the game.
Yes, okay, let's go.
Just finish it?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I need to sell my stock first. Hold on.
Hold up.
I'll be right back, Ruth.
Ruth, just hold that thought. Hold on, I have to go to the ATM.
I gotta do my computer nerdy stuff. I think she wants Coke too.
Be right back. Have to do
doing computer nerdy things.
Okay. The game will be done.
It will be done.
Oh, I gotta pay the loan?
Yeah.
Okay, but now I can beat the game. I got it. I can do it right now. Or I can melt the game out a little more, but let's just finish. Oh, what? Okay, Ruth, I'm not done with you.
Let's do this. Bam!
We've received your final payment on
Yay!
The castle. Thank you for using our bank.
Yay! Congratulations! You have succeeded in carrying out the Benedict legacy. Now everything is yours. All yours. You've proven your ability to successfully run a marriage, money, and a social environment.
Not like people in Milton. They can't do a
bird!
They can't do marriage, money, because they're buying like million-dollar houses and they
and
can't afford it.
And selling them like a year later. Oh my gosh. Foreclosure. To top it off, you've carried out the last wishes of a dying man. You're a real Benedict. Let's get some eggs, Benedict. Yeah!
Look at that
freaking castle. It's haunted, sucker!
2.5 million for that thing.
Oh
I
my gosh,
where.
That's cheap, yo. Yeah! Check out that ending.
This is top secret?
It says top secret trader info. LOL. Honey, you're so good. I married the best.
Good job. Your uncle will be proud.
Well, I bet you couldn't do it again.
Do it again. Do
yeah.
it again.
Okay, let's try to beat my... What was the time? Let's try to beat it.
Hit the timer. Bam.
Hit reset. Let's start
Hit
over.
Hit reset. Let's go again. Oh, my.
If I did that, my ears would hurt.
Yeah.
And my mane would... How about some larger pets? I can quit my work and be a chauffeur.
It's not bad. We got through this whole thing. Then we get all the people that we met in the game. We're going to be all like, hey, you the best. You're ready to buy more mansions. And that's kind of the lame thing about this game. It's like pretty much it had you have like, there's a lot to it. I mean, this game is like friggin' hard as hell, right?
This is a total like...
Happy. Enjoy it, enjoy it.
Yuki Katsuna Hiro Suki.
Dance with the couch. Let's do this.
Tad Nomura Toshimurai script.
Oh man, it's so much fun.
Fat issue. Hirosuki Saka, Fred Ishii again. Fred Ishii did stock data. Instruction stock data. Directors.
I hope you guys had as much fun as we did playing this game.
Oh, 7th guess is $1.50 on Steam?
Yo,
that's a good deal.
That's a good deal.
It's worth $1.50. I wouldn't pay more than $5 for today's prices because it's like an old game.
I'm now officially a dork. I'm now officially a kumquat. There you go, Wall Street Kid. You don't have to play this game now, because we played it for you.
Sorry, I stepped away. He's like, you missed the game. Sorry, AnnK.
Play it again. I stepped away from the thingy.
I think that's the end. That's
it. It just freezes on the soft feel.
There's no sorry. Do you want to play again? Oh.
Your password.
Why would I want that?
Why would we want the password to get all the way to the end?
I wonder what happens next.
I wonder what happens next. You see, it would be really neat if you could keep playing the game and keep playing the stock market, like, indefinitely. But, yeah. I don't know. Oh, man, it's like 10 o'clock. That wasn't so bad.
Look at this.
Look at that.
Have you ever played Baseball Stars?
Baseball Stars?
Yeah, I remember as a kid, I used to play that with my friend, and he just knew how to get those home runs. It was so exciting to see that ball go, and then like goes, and then like it goes home run with the big thing, and the guy just like jogs. It's pretty fun. It's a good game.
I don't have anything planned after this. We have to wash this couch, though.
Okay, let's get that couch.
Okay, so we're going to end the stream. Actually, let me see who else is streaming, because I thought this was going to take a lot longer.
cool.
But you gotta drop your dad off at the airport, but who else is streaming?
What time do you usually go until, like, 11 or 10:30?
Oh, Macaw's playing. I usually, well, sometimes, like, you know, I'll play for, like, a good 4 hours and stuff, but let me see.
Fuzzy Pickles. Nack Chumpa. Bobby Jr.
So, here, let me do this. Let me go. There we go. So you guys go watch Macaw because he's playing, like, another game. Thanks for tuning in.
A cool sentence.
Next Sunday. Bye-bye. Bye. And exit. Oh.